Good morning, Mr. Savlani. Thanks for joining us. We are looking at your numbers, which have been turned out to be quite well. We just wanted to understand the volumes growth for PVC and the CPVC segments for this particular quarter.
See, basically the consolidated volume growth in the last year was 16%, though the industry was not growing that great, but our company has delivered a very robust growth of 16%. And going forward also, we are seeing the similar kind of growth we are expecting in FY19 also.
So your margins have also come ahead in the fourth quarter. Is this likely because of the price hikes, and to what extent has the input costs aided your expansion in margins?
I think 15-16% is the margin which are going to be a sustainable kind of margin. Last quarter was the abnormal margin of 17% plus, because last quarter is always peak in our industry. So because of economy of scale advantage, the margin was around 17%. But I think going forward, 15% plus margin is a sustainable margin for FY19.
So there's been a decline in your realizations in your plastics business for two quarters straight. Can you tell us a little more about why this is and if we can expect this trend to continue?
I think Q4, the realization was declined mainly because the crude price was low. So because of that, the plastic price was low at the international level. But now from the Q1 onward, there is a sizable improvement into the pricing of the polymer. So in this coming quarter, we are seeing that volume growth will be lesser than the value growth. So value growth will be more than 15%. If the volume growth will be 15-16%, then the value may be 18-20% kind of level.
And in your adhesive segment, how is Resinova and Sealit doing in terms of traction right now?
I think Resinova is doing very well. Even the kind of top line growth Resinova has delivered in last year and kind of consistent improvement into the EBITDA margin, we are very happy with the performance of the Resinova. Sealit, last year there was a top line growth, but because of this US losses, the EBITDA margin was around 5-6%. So this year we are expecting that the US will start performing well. In fact, it has already started giving us a good number. So we are expecting that this year, even overseas operation of Sealit will going to give us minimum double digit EBITDA margin. And Resinova will also going to give us a reasonably very high margin.
So also a word on your distribution network and the expansion. What are the areas that you're looking to expand from here on? And how are you laying out the plans in terms of expansion, keeping competition in mind?
If I talking to the adhesive side first, the adhesive, we already completed the expansion in last year. So now we have a very high capacity available with Resinova. We can take care of turnover up to 1200 crore. So that much of capacity there. Right now the utilization is hardly, I can say, 40% kind of level. So we have enough capacity available in Resinova because we have increased the capacity in the current year. Coming to the pipe side, last year we have increased the capacity of around 13,000 metric ton. And in the coming year, FY19, this Rajasthan plant will be operational. There we are expecting the 22,700 metric ton capacity. And then the south plant, which we are targeting to double the capacity. So additional 20,000 will be coming from the south. So now there will be a sizable capacity available with the company. Around 190,000 metric ton capacity will be ready by FY19 closing. So we have now enough capacity, and now we are going to focus on the growth, because with this Rajasthan plant, we want to increase our volume into the north market, where our presence is very low. And similarly, in the southern market, our plant is working at a 90% plus capacity. So once this double capacity will be there, so additional 20,000 will be available. We are expecting that segment will also going to grow in a big way. So we are very positive about the growth in the coming years.